Honorable President, sir, Minister for Communication and IT, Shri Kapil Sibal ji, Chairman UPSC, Minister for Information Broadcasting, Shri Manish Tiwari ji, members UPSC, member National Disaster Management Authority, Shri Duggal ji, editors, friends from the media, and distinguished guests. I deem it a matter of honor and privilege to extend to you all a very hearty welcome on this occasion of release of postage stamp and first day cover in honor of Sahir Ludhianvi. At the very outset, I would like to express my deepest gratitude to Honorable President of India for having very kindly agreed to do the honors for Sahir Ludhianvi and at this historic venue of Rashtrapati Bhavan. Born on this day, 92 years ago, Sahir Ludhianvi was the pen name of Abdul Hai. Sahir started to write nazams and ghazals early and became immensely popular even as a college student. Iqbal, the favorite of Sahir, had once on All India Radio recited a nazm, Is chaman mein paida honge bulbule shiraz bhi, sainkdo sahir bhi honge sahib ejaz bhi. This inspired the budding poet to write under the pen name of Sahir, a magician. How true, he indeed became a magician with words. His most well-known and seminal work, Talkhiyan, was published from Lahore in 1944. The ghazals, casting a spell on the contemporary Hindi and Urdu literature, brought him instant recognition. Later, he edited Preet Ladi and Shahra. The sensitive and youthful rebel in Sahir and his portrayal of emotional dilemmas faced by the poor and the anguished often led people to identify him with leftists. A crusader against society's false and hollow values, he continued to write with his trademark of heightened realism. While those days most of the Urdu poetry revolved around women, beauty and wine, Sahir was entirely at a different level as he addressed the fundamental problems of human conditions and injustice, whether in society or in love. The Bengal famine of the early 40s had moved him and made him a rebel. He wrote extensively on the zulm of the British and got associated with Ballad Sahni, Chetan Anand and Salil Chaudhary in IPTA for some time. But he could not resist the magnetic pull of the film world and shifted to Mumbai in 1949. One of his first songs, Thandi Hawaein Lehra Ke Aayein, was in the 1950 film Naujawan, a song which retains its freshness and popularity even today. With the success of his lyrics in the 1951 film Bazi, he instantly became a household name throughout the country. Earlier, at the time of independence, he had written Ab koi gulshan na ujde, ab watan azad hai. But later, his disappointment was reflected in Ye mehlon, ye takhton, ye taajon ki dunya, ye insaan ke dushman samajon ki dunya, ye daulat ke bhookhe rivajon ki dunya, ye dunya agar mil bhi jaye to kya hai. In the tinsel world, it was only Gurudat who could fully exploit and portray the range as well as potential of Sahir as in Pyasa of 1957. Gurudat had read Talkhiyan and wanted to do a film with the hero as a poet. He wanted to name this film Kashmakash. Even when he was making other films like Bazi or Arpar, Kashmakash was always at the back of his mind. Finally, he offered the role to Dilip Kumar, who backed out at the last minute. Gurudat then became the poet hero and Kashmakash became Pyasa. Sahir's fame rose sky high with Pyasa as, for the first time in film industry, a lyricist had assumed a pivotal position on center stage. Sahir wrote extensively on various themes. Amongst his patriotic lyrics, the famous Naya Daur song, Ya Desh Hai Veer Jawano Ka, Albelo Ka, Mastano Ka, remains on top, along with Saathi Haath Badhana. Naya Daur dealt with the problem of man versus machine in a developing society. It was also one of the favorites of Pandit Nehru. Inspired by Iqbal's Mazhab Nahi Sikhata Aapas Mein Bair Rakhna, Sahir wrote, तू हिंदू बनेगा ना मुसलमान बनेगा, इंसान की औलाद है इंसान बनेगा. हिज लिरिक्स फॉर फिर सुबह होगी केम इन फॉर क्रिटिसिज्म एंड सम कॉल्ड हिम इक्नोक्लास्टिक बट देन ही हैड ऑलवेज स्पोकन फॉर दी हैव नॉट्स होपिंग एंड प्रोमिसिंग फॉर होप ही रोट. वह सुबह कभी तो आएगी इन काली सदियों के सर से जब रात का आंचल ढलकेगा जब दुख के बादल पिघलेंगे जब सुख का सागर छलकेगा जब धरती नगमे गाएगी वह सुबह कभी तो आएगी. एंड देन लेटर वह सुबह हम ही से आएगी जब धरती करवट बदलेगी जब पाप घरौंदे फूटेंगे दुनिया अमन और खुशहाली के फूलों से सजाई जाएगी वह सुबह हम ही से आएगी. साहिर्स इमेंस कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन टू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ लिटरेचर एंड आर्ट्स हैज़ बीन वेल रिकग्नाइज्ड. ही वॉज अवॉर्डेड द फिल्म फेयर ट्रॉफी फॉर कभी कभी इन 77 एंड ताजमहल इन 64. ही वॉज ऑल्सो कन्फर्ड पद्मश्री इन 1971 बिसाइड सेवरल अदर अवार्ड्स. टुडे ऑल्सो हैपन्स टू बी द इंटरनेशनल वीमेंस डे. थ्रू हिज पोएट्री साहिर ट्राइड टू फोकस ऑन देयर प्रॉब्लम्स एज फार बैक एज 1959. His portrayal of women in Sadhana remains unsurpassed to date with the famous Aurat ne janam diya mardon ko, mardon ne use bazaar diya, jab ji chaha masla kuchla, jab ji chaha dutkar diya. Versatility was Sahir's forte. It was not as if he always wrote serious poetry. For instance, he resolved a dilemma faced by Raj Kapoor and Nutan in Dil Hi To Hai. इन अ वेरी लाइट हार्टेड मैनर. तुम अगर मुझको ना चाहो तो कोई बात नहीं, तुम किसी और को चाहोगी तो मुश्किल होगी. इट वॉज टूअर्ड द एंड ऑफ हिज कैरियर दैट साहिर रोट फॉर कभी कभी. मैं पल दो पल का शायर हूँ, मसरूफ़ जमाना मेरे लिए क्यों वक्त अपना बर्बाद करे. एंड सिग्निफिकेंटली इट हैज़ टेकन अस मोर देन 30 ईयर्स आफ्टर हिज डेथ टू ऑनर दिस नेशनल आइकॉन आइडेंटिफाइड एज ए पीपल्स पोएट. His down-to-earth approach and his use of common man's perspective in the fine arts of ghazal and nazm would forever remain irreplaceable. With these words, I welcome you all once again on this historic occasion.